you to have a quiet early game. So I think the sniper is a possible option. Oh, Weaver is even better. Yeah, Weaver is pretty good as well. Into a Sladar and Drone Ranger, it's kind of make it less Weaver less impactful in the game.
Yeah,
but I worry about as I said earlier, Drone Ranger is really scared of Pudge. When you're pushing, you're hitting tower. If you don't position yourself carefully, so I believe maybe he will go for Hem of Dominator, and you have to place carefully.
Put your creep right on top of you or by your side.
Yeah, definitely a point to consider. A lot of games can be won or lost because of a Pudge hook. The guy can miss all the Pudge hooks in the game, but then at that one key point when you're trying to hook up, when you go up the high ground, you get hooked in with your Aegis, you lose both of it, and then you just lose the game from there. It's the momentum. We're gonna into the match right now. And we're gonna see how things play out. We have here on the Radiant Bazaar. They really, really need this win. The X Warriors Gaming. We have an X Nova playing the Wisp. We have Afu playing the Dazzle. Choice of hats actually. And Nana could play the OD on the mid lane. And of course, lastly, we have the off lane Ben. You wanna introduce RRQ?
Okay. For RRQ, we have Koala. Koala on the offlaner, as Legion Commander, and then we have Zephyr on Pudge. Wow, okay. Then Eden is playing CM, Kel'Thuzad, the carry, is playing Weaver, and as usual, Yabby, which is Invoker. Yeah, and remember when you said a fail Invoker yesterday?
Yeah.
I believe it was Yabby, right?
Yeah.
Yabby's Invoker.
He got destroyed by PL.
I don't know how much of that was his fault or the matchup being terrible. There was a bad rider in his lane nonstop. Actually, I want to ask you about Eden. How much do you know about this guy?
Not much actually. Frankly speaking, I don't really know.
Because a lot of players were saying like, "Oh, Chad Eden Senpai" or something like that. So I thought that maybe he's some big shot in the Indonesian scene or something.
I think that question you have to ask ADTR. He's very familiar with the current scene of Indonesian Dota.
Yeah, probably gonna have to ask him if he's on the panel later on. But for now, we're just gonna see what's happened around the map. Okay, let's see if we have any observer. What's actually none placed down yet. Am I blind? No, no observer was placed down just yet.
I think this is a psychological impact from the previous game.
Yeah, they're just afraid that it gets dewatered. Yeah. So they're like, alright, let's just hold back on it. And a very early smoke out coming here from the Fudge. Sephiroth and Eden looking for some shenanigans on the bottom lane, helping maybe help that Legion get a quick and early first blood and scoot her laning phase off to a good start. Kind of Pudge hiding in the trees there. He's gone for level 1 rot, so that's gonna have the consistency. You know, you're gonna have that ability to keep the chase going.
Yep.
The IO does ping to the side there, so he does suspect a little bit of foul play. Sephir.
Baiting,
and here comes Eden. The Pudge is here as well. They don't have Grave, and the heal bomb though, it does do quite a bit of damage. The right click's coming in, they get the kill. Koala, and can he actually get out now? No, it will not. CM, one more snowball will do the trick, and it's two heroes down. RRQ strike hard and fast, securing first blood and another kill within a minute of playtime. Nova, the only surviving member of his tri-lane now, and this is good, right? Play aggressive against the tri-lane with Wisp.
Yeah, because they know they don't have any disable lockdown. They're so passive. It's like two passive supporters supporting a passive carry, Drone Ranger.
Yeah, it's like prestigious game, right? When they had the Dazzle and the Omni Knight.
Yeah.
Timbersaw. Like, bro, you're not getting in.
The thing is, when you play passive heroes in tri lane, you give the opponent more space to make the plays. It's like Pudge going mid, Pudge going bottom. So it's like constantly you're being following the pace of your opponent. So I think this is not really a good idea, but it could be that they are in this second predicament is because they are like lack of confidence.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because they feel that their playstyle is not working. They're over aggressive, bizarre, normal playstyle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it could be that as well. And you know, draw strats might be powerful and everything with ranged heroes, but level 1 is a stretch. You know, you don't have that kind of firepower at level 1. And I like what the Crystal Maiden is doing. You know, you just don't hang around the lane, and this invisibility rune is going to ruin some lives.
But yeah, speaking of it, the Crystal Maiden has been spending quite a bit of time.
Did you notice that when he picked the invisible, he purposely walks toward the right side to give a because there's a small window where they can see before he's totally invisible. So actually, he's baiting for mid. You see, middle. He thought that he's going back bottom. This is a very good trick by.
Yeah, and he used his banish. He just used his banish, and here comes the rot hug, and there you go, Sunstrike, kaboom! Down goes the OD, TP support not in time, and really, really little that the Dazzle could have done anyway. Yeah. And
really good fake play by Zephyr.
Yeah, it's just in case there's an observer watching, they'll think like, okay, he's going back bottom, so bottom care, right? And then the middle, like, all right, I can farm. But there was no observer ward scouting that anyway, so.
But
what you pointed out makes a lot of sense. It's just the little mind games that you really want to have in Dota. And right now we have the tri lane still on their toes because you don't know where the Pudge is, and one hook means, oh, wow, Pudge is going back middle. It's like, all right, time to ruin this guy's life. And Nana, we already talked about him having a bad day. Yeah. His day is about to, the problems are about to compound, and here comes the cold snap, and with the rod, he's gonna be in a lot of trouble. His IO coming in, it's not dazzled, there will be no grave. The hook comes in, there's the heal, and Invoker actually falls, and a great TP rotation comes in, allowing them to get a double kill for the mid laner, and Bazaar strikes back, so now it's 2-3. A nice little bit of rotation.
Good rotation from no.
Heal bomb! Bottom lane, Legion Commander nearly going down there to the Dazzle. Had to play careful there. Koala might have to pour still. Play safe. Haste rune. No problem. Gonna find that one.
And he's doing pretty good at top. Yeah. I mean, being soloing against
Weaver. Yeah, Crystal Maiden has shown herself. It's a level 4 slaughter, so it's quite challenging for his Crystal Maiden to force him out of lane. And he even got a bottle so that he can take the bounty runes and put them to use. OD. Very tanky there. Level 5 armor, I think the 5 base armor of OD, allowing him to survive that punch gank.
Yeah. And Evoker didn't have his Sunstrike at the time.
Yeah, no Sunstrike there. Unable to get a quick kill, but now Nana has 2 kills on the board. He's gonna be feeling pretty comfortable about this lane. How's Ben looking? Level 4.5. I think this is the first time I've seen. Well, not first time, but it's been a first time in a while that I've seen a Slaughter have such a good lane.
Yeah, after all, he's like soloing against the Weaver, and it's a good thing to pick out the poor man's shield.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I think Weaver is going for the kill here, but missing on the bugs, and that is gonna be bad. Tsukuchi dodging that, trying to dodge out that Slaughter's crush. But if the bugs hit, I think he would have gone for it.
Yep. And if the bug hit, I think Slaughter would have gone for a teleport scroll.
Yeah.
And just teleport home.
Oh, but they're diving him anyway. The Sun Strikes here. The Frostbite could be enough to hold Ben there for Kael'thasa to finish him off. And
good rotation from Eden.
Yeah, nice movements from Eden. And see, this is how Crystal Maiden should be played. Yeah. You know, level 4 Crystal Maiden at the 5-minute mark, just making moves around the map, just threatening the offlane, threatening anywhere that you possibly find a opening here. Wait for OD, use his banish, going for the Frostbite. Because Crystal Maiden can just farm up the enemy jungle. Look at this. She's farming the enemy's side of the map, getting the EXP, and just really, I know some of my friends make this joke, 5-lane map. You know, 5 lanes, you have one of your own jungles, use the enemy's jungle in the 3 lanes. And this is Crystal Maiden that's doing her job and maximizing her hero's potential.
And it's like constantly have to keep the top and middle Bori. Yeah. So Odie will have to watch out for them.
I don't think this is a gankable lane for now. The regeneration gonna just be nabbed up by the OD, and maybe he used the banish. Nope, gonna try and
Punch is coming.
Yep, they are coming in. The Observer scouts this out
from all sides.
Observer scouts this. The IO is coming in again. Frostbite, there we go. Rodhug, the Sunstrike as well. He walks into it. He goes down. Where was the banish? He was just. Oh, he just used it.
He just used it. Yeah,
used it on Invoker aggressively. And that is. I mean, it's a real bind, right?
Yeah.
You try to use it for control.
But he should have realized that by now that it is necessary for him to keep the banish for his safety.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like this is not the first time he's being ganked. This is like the fourth time.
Mm-hmm.
So he should be more careful when he uses the beam as prison, especially when the two heroes are missing, the two supports are missing.
Yeah. Like you said, tilting. It's also a little bit of a bind. Like I mentioned, you want to use, because this Astro Imprisonment is how OD wins his lane. See, he uses the banish because he wants to like to put the invoker out of CSing.
Yeah.
For a bit. So, you know, if you're not using your banish, then the invoker already wins because of that. So, you know, it's kind of a hard decision to make. But now Eden looking for another wraparound here on Ben. I think it's gonna be an easy one. The bounce will follow through, and with that frostbite, that sunstrike will come. Oh, and doesn't get the frost, doesn't get the sunstrike ready. The invoker a little bit too antsy there. Him out,
but it's kind of waste the time.
Yeah, and waste a little bit of time. The IO looking to wrap around, but doesn't get anything done. The sentry ward will scout out this observer here, though. So
I think he must have thought that the CM was gonna bite first instead of Nova.
Yeah. So just preemptively sun striking there. Of course, the invokers usually these off lane sun strikes. You usually want to flick. It's usually a flick, kind of flick shot. You just click it and then you look back in your lane. So you don't really have a lot of time to think about it. And, but so far, this Legion commander, it's having a great time. I mean, this is a Legion that's got 34 last hits, level 6 now. Phase boots.
Yeah, given that the two supports keep have to teleport around to save me top, and then it's like they are passive supporters. They hold no threat to the Legion commander.
Crystal Maiden gonna feed here. Yep, definitely gonna feed. There you go, Ayo.
Finally, it's like, it's like, he's been going around there, sneaking around. Finally, they got him.
Okay, our Koala has to be very careful there, boost himself up. There's the silence as well. The Drow Ranger might pick him off, but no, it's not going to be enough damage. He will not strike her down. And hey, look there, the shrine is ready. So he's going to top himself back up. And
just like new.
Yeah, just like new. Coil 2's out. Oh, dropping low. Probably has a time lapse out of that. He's going to time lapse, heal himself a little bit. And we have more rotations, waiting for more punch action.
The draw range is only level 6 compared to the Weaver level 9.
Yeah,
that's huge difference.
That's a big point to note as well. The draw ranger had to share experience with.
Oh, there's a smoke action here.
Dazzle,
from CM and Budge.
Yeah, good movement. They're probably gonna find Dazzle, who is actually low on mana. So they see him. They see Drow. I think Drow's even better target there.
Oh, nice dropping silence.
That. Okay, that's a weird sunstrike, but they still have Pudge. They're gonna commit. The hook goes wide and will not find the Drow. So that is going to
really
be
really good reaction from Jit.
Yeah, that's gonna be a very happy archer. Stay alive. He goes for a raw Dragonlance. No threats, nothing. Just Dragonlance right away. Just go for the range and play it safe.
I think the extra amount of HP is good. Since the lack of burst in RRQ.
Yeah, and that was actually a perfect opportunity to gank them as well. Dazzle had no mana to grave. There was no way out for Drow if he had got caught by the Sunstrike. So, a little mistake on RRQ's part, but Nana has managed to reclaim some of that CS in the middle lane without that Invoker's presence, but I think they're making a move down to the bottom again. Walla maybe looking to eke out some dual damage for himself. Pudge looking for a fish. Do we find it? Oh, Pudge looking in. He sees the Dazzle. That's gonna hook. It's gonna be perfect. Lands on him, and there you go. The Grave is there. And I think the Sunstrike is going to be. Oh, it's gonna airball completely as he does pull his Dazzle away with the relocate. Very well done there. Koala is gonna pay. And the Banish goes out on the CM that tries to save the Legion Commander. In the end, gonna feed her own life away. So two kills going the way of Bazaar in a gank gone wrong. So quick rotations there from. Quick movement there for Nova with the relocate,
and
saving
the
Dazzle.
Also the three-man silence. So Legion couldn't do much with that, with the IO ulti.
Yeah, very well done. And that was even after a nice hook there from the Thunder Punch. No, hooks in the car. doesn't get the hook on the Drow Ranger. Would have been nice. The bite under the tower would have guaranteed the duel. And the Legion really needs to start racking in the dual damage. I think that is the main concern with picking Legion.
Yeah, it's still at zero.
Yeah, still at zero. The dream is to get at least 20 by level 15, no, by level 10. You have these markers that you really want to meet. But Yavi, how's he doing as an invoker? Do you play invoker a lot yourself?
Well, frankly, I don't play invoker at all.
Okay, you don't play Invoker at all. But you know, I've noticed a trend. You know, for all the high level Invokers, 6K, 7K, you know, some of them on my friend list. I watched them play, and I've always noticed that they get their Aghanim's Midas by around the 20-minute mark. Is that a standard timing?
Well, with the current meta is like, yeah, that's. It's also based on the games. I think it's nowadays the meta is like just rush for Scepter.
Yeah, but is 20-minute mark the usual timing that they get it?
I think that's
Frostbite,
normal.
Man in trouble. There's the Nova to start things off. Oh, again, not starting with the Frostbite, but not gonna be punished for that this time. I think Eden, maybe you wanna consider starting with Frostbite this time. Yes, misled his Invoker a couple of times now. But they still get the kill, so no harm, no foul. But this Slaughter is very close to his Blink Dagger, actually.
Yeah, he's a really happy Slaughter. He has a really good game, actually, despite that being picked off a few times.
Okay, what are your thoughts on this Legion not going Blink or Shadow Blade first and going for Blade Mail?
Well, now this is the current meta. For a meta now, you have the max overwhelming odds.
Okay.
And then they go for Face Boot and directly Blade Mail.
Okay.
It gives them better, maybe. Better initiation with the without the dagger, they can have the higher movement speed to rush towards the enemy. But I don't see how they can do in this game, because they need a really good initiation for.
Yeah, the Legion's kind of like their starter,
yeah,
right? It's like the Slaughter that needs to blink in.
That means they have like they take a leak of faith, hoping that the bash will hook one person.
Yep, and meanwhile Slaughter finds the Invoker that he goes with the Tornado. Really quick reaction set, the Frostbite is ready as well. But here comes the Legion, the overwhelming odds! Bloody hell, nukes them all down. And Qualla nearly goes down to the Drow Ranger himself, but now they will escape. The Amplified damage is adding into a lot of that injury. But the score will be at 6-9 right now. RRQ still in the lead after that first dual win by Qualla.
I'm actually quite surprised that Bazaar still haven't decided to place Observer Ward around this area.
Yeah, they've been ganked there from that side many times.
For them. Exactly. That's like a really huge blind spot because they still have the mid tower.
Oh, I think he might die here. The OD ultimate might come out. There's a time lapse. No, not even needed. Got the kill right away with the Banish. Nice reaction there from the OD, knowing not to have to use that ultimate to kill off the Weaver.
The Greater was too greedy for the tower.
Yeah. Now he gets none of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, Crystal Maiden. Yeah, Crystal Maiden has been doing a lot of warding, a lot of dewarding. I think Mr. Eden here really giving us a crash course on how to play this Crystal Maiden properly.
Yep. Yeah. X-Nova can take a lesson or two.
Yeah, but his IO has been pretty decent. Oh, there's the Banish and there's the Relocate as well. I think Crystal Maiden wants a piece out from this. Yep, she says, nope, not going there. And no stuns here means Eden will port out in time. So they do relocate for a punch kill, which is nice. It can transition into a tower.
I think it's a tier 2. It can go down very fast with the Ranger.
Yeah, they have Glyph. We'll see if they decide to defend this. There are two heroes making their way down bottom, so I do believe that is the plan. Arjit, meanwhile, still gonna sit back to plink a few more arrows in that tower, but now gonna port away. So they do get movement down the bottom, force out the Glyph, so not gonna be too sad about it.
Yeah, it's worth it.
Okay, how's Invoker looking?
So, LC still haven't, the next item that he wants to buy. Haven't decided what he wants to buy next, I guess.
Yeah, Invoker is actually 600 gold away from Aghanim, so
16 minutes, that's really good.
Yeah, that's actually a really fast timing.
Yeah.
You know, when I say the 20-minute Aghanim, it's usually with a Eels. Or if you're doing a really bad game, you're having a really bad game, and still get it by 20 minutes, so I think this is this is a really fast Aghanim scepter.
After all, he has been having a really good game with all the ganks coming for him.
Yeah.
Going away.
Ooh, Nana. He is looking to get a jump on this Weaver, who has just used Tsukuchi. And does he stick around for more? There's the 4-star forward. He uses the Banish, not knowing that there are bad guys in the side. And scouting out the CMS Slaughter. Slaughter does have the Blink Dagger, though. He's gonna hook out his girlfriend. Yep, there you go. Eden survives there. Maybe not. Probably not. frost arrows land in her back, and that's gonna be a death there. Poor CM. And Sephir, meanwhile, has to run. There's another Blink Dagger on Slaughter. He has another crush. I think it's time to go in to heal up the Pudge. There's a lot of damage. The Dwarf comes out a little bit optimistic on that one. No Dazzle, but I think Legion dies anyway. And the winner is Nana. And that's a four hero wipe. Invoker coming in a little bit late. Oh, missing the combo as well. Yappy, what are you doing? There's the Ghost Walk. Do they have detection? Yes, they do. They sprinkle the dust, and that's going to be a team wipe.
5-0.
Favoring Bazaar. 5-0 indeed. Oh,
boy. That was a disaster.
That was like trying to save a falling sand castle. Yep. That exactly is that. You know,
they could have just left the CM to die.
Yeah?
It wasn't worth it.
And never save dead heroes. That's
it. Was just a CM, not even a core.
Don't save feeders. But yeah, the overcommitting on trying to fight one by one, Invoker coming in at the last moment, that was just all over the place. And RQ's inexperience starting to show here. Bazaar punishing.
Yeah.
Middle tower has fallen. The lapse in strategy, and now Eden. They lose another tier 1 tower. It's Pudge picked up Midas, okay. Midas Pudge. Over, building into that mechanism. Burst steel, very standard stuff. How what's the OD? I think we say Nana is tilting and everything, but he's been playing decent. Oh, yeah. It's gonna be a smoke on smoke. Why is CM leading the charge to heal up the CM? There's the tornado. CM is down, there's a hook, he lands in the OD, that's a perfect bite there. It was a duel, maybe a duel, where's the duel? But the Grave comes in and the relocate as well. There's so many heroes. Would have been a winner. He actually was the winner. That's two duel wins now. 28 bonus damage. He says, thank you, sir. Gets another one. CM buying back and dying again. And the relocate is just pulling him out. OD, the hook magnet, but there's the force stamp and the banished Grave. Everyone's just saving their quarterback. Nana.
Still alive.
Yeah, he's still alive, and look at his HP. Nearly full, and now Yabby gonna have to run away. The EMP is not gonna deter them. They are gonna be brought down. Nana with the Wicked Stick orbs him down, and now Pudge lost in the woods. 20-9, two back-to-back team wipes with a double death.
Yeah, double death. Double die back.
A double death on their Crystal Maiden.
They had more than one buybacks. Pudge bought back too.
Okay.
Eden and CM bought back.
And they died again.
Yeah, double die back. That's seven death,
full team wipe, no heroes lost. They just saved their OD over and over. There's relocate, there's duel. Told you Legion Commandos, bad luck. Bad luck.
And you still have no idea what he's gonna get.
Yeah.
And I think even if he's like having a really good game, I don't think he can do much with having out against two healers and outward destroyer. There's no way he can get any damage.
It was lucky that he got the 10 already. I think that might be the last one he gets. He's donated 28 now. Look at OD. Happy as a kid. Look here.
And, yeah. And he also have the Drow Ranger aura. Oh my god.
Yeah.
His damage is insane. And he didn't use his ultimate. He didn't use anything Eclipse during the war. During the team fight.
Crystal Maiden now starting to be a burden as the game slips more and more into that mid game. Arjit picking up that Aegis with the Yasha, Hurricane Pike feeling very comfortable. I think now RQ, you know, that early Aghanim Scepter not feeling as great now, even though the Invoker did get it early, unable to capitalize on it. You can see that Blink Dagger, really desperate for mobility.
LC is getting Dagger as well.
Finally!
Yeah, his Dagger is out now.
Alright, so but Nana gets a kill on Eden meanwhile, and we'll see if RJ gets caught, but that's an Aegis on the Drow Ranger. There's a relocate in the back there, ready to bail him out.
And this is the tower and shrine where the team can TP.
Yeah, so. I definitely think that this is a mistake going in first, but we're gonna have Ben immediately going in for the crush. The Weaver melts to the heal bomb, and that's that. Your Weaver is dead. Denies the tower as well. I think that's the second tower. He's denied the tower against the Weaver. This guy greedy for that real estate. Not gonna get what he wants. Dies twice for it.
Yeah, early game he was playing with, you know, like just going with the creeps, just farming the whole game. He had a good farm in the early game. And we still don't get to see him in real action. I mean, like, his farm, all the free farm that he had, haven't been proven useful.
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, he's going for Manta for first item, I think, to counter silence from the Ranger.
Yeah, Manta Weaver, that's uncommon, to say the least. Usually it's a Desolator. Whoa, Pedro's waiting to pull someone in, but Nana says, let me save you the trouble. I'll hop right in, takes out the Invoker. The heal's not enough. The Duel gonna try and kill the Slaughter, but instead gonna donate damage over to the winner, the Radiant. Winning more duels than a Dire here. Slaughter with the bonus 14. Gonna be pretty happy about that. Eden gonna sit behind, twiddles thumbs. What am I gonna do here? The answer is nothing. Wait for the end. And buyback here from the Invoker, looking to make something happen. Nana says, I'm gonna take this 28 damage and chuck it at your Rex. And, well, there's nothing much they can really do about this. They're just gonna sit there and watch their base fall apart. And, well, I don't know, man. How. This game. What can I do if it's three?
Well, at this point, there's nothing much for them to do. Even if, for example, the Weaver complete his Manta, okay, he can survive from the silence, draw silence, but he will still die to the OD. I think there's no way he can tank all the damage from OD.
Yeah.
The OD is like such a beast now, so fat.
That Legion pick is definitely not working out. RNQ gonna look for that. Ooh, who's that in the middle? That's Invoker. He goes down. That Eclipse takes them out. And the Legion commander as well. No chance at all. Nana is back, boys and girls. Looks like Lunch was all he needed to be good at this. And he's going in. He's taking names. And Sephir going to go down. A triple kill. The Silence just missing the Weaver. Kel'Thuzad's gonna scoot away and type good game into the alt chat. And that's gonna be that. Bazaar knocked.